Electrolytic capacitors are probably the number one cause of failed electronic devices these days. Over time, heat and aging in general cause their ESR, the equivalent series resistance, to increase. At some point, that will lead to the capacitor losing its capability to read itself in the circuit properly. While sometimes the capacitor will show symptoms like bulging on top surface, it's not always visible to the outside. Capacitor's ESR can be tested using something called ESR meter or tester. Of course they can be both, but why not make a simple one yourself as an afternoon project? Once you have the circuit designed and tested, you can order your PCBs from sponsor of this video, PCBWay.com. In addition to PCBs, they also have other services you can use in your project, like 3D printing and CNC milling. Once I'm sure I have enough use for ESR tester, I will definitely order the PCBs from PCBWay.com. If you have searched for ESR tester schematics, there are multiple different options, but many of them share the similar working principle. I will implement my ESR tester the same way and will describe each part of the circuit. That way you can take the information and adapt it to your preferred components. First section is 100 kHz signal. This could be done with 555 timer, operational amplifier circuit, some logic ICs, or a microcontroller. I have done it using PSoC 4 in PSoC Creator's configurator. I have configured a 200 kHz clock and a toggle flip-flop, because clock cannot be directly connected to a GPIO pin. The flip-flop divides the input clock by 2 and outputs 100 kHz, in this case directly to the output pin. Next section is stepping down the original 100 kHz signal from higher voltage to something like 200 mV peak-to-peak AC. That is low enough to not trigger anything in the most circuits. I have connected the 100 kHz output from GPIO pin through a DC blocking series capacitor to the primary of this transformer. Another side of the primary is connected to ground. The transformer is hand wound 200-ish turns primary, 10-ish on the secondary. 5V peak to peak on the primary will be transformed to about 250 mV peak to peak on the secondary. Next section is where the tested capacitor will be connected and it will affect the output voltage. Fixed resistor is bottom half of the voltage divider. Top half is the tested capacitor's ESR plus the capacitive reactance. But that capacitive reactance will be very small for most capacitors at 100 kHz. Because voltage output of that divider will be less than 250 mV peak to peak, it needs to be amplified for easier measurement. In this inverting amplifier circuit, the AC signal from the measured capacitors and fixed resistors voltage divider gets amplified and biased at 1/2 of the VCC. I'm using internal operational amplifier of the PSoC 4, but it's just a regular op-amp. You can use generic op-amp just as well. The output of the operational amplifier is AC voltage inversely proportional to the capacitor's ESR, but with DC component. Next part of the circuit gets rid of the DC component and also outputs the amplitude level of the AC signal in DC voltage. In this case, capacitor blocks the DC and diode plus capacitor form an envelope detector that will output DC voltage that represents the amplitude of the AC signal's peak voltage. It's good idea to include a resistor that drains the capacitor in case the next section doesn't do that automatically. Last part is measuring the voltage on this capacitor. You can connect a digital multimeter to this point, route it to the microcontroller's ADC, or add an analog voltmeter to have a better visual output. The output will be at its highest point when the capacitor to be tested is replaced with short circuit. Infinite ESR or open circuit will result in 0V output. Amplification of the operational amplifier circuit and voltage output of the transformer set the maximum voltage. If your voltmeter or microcontroller's ADC has range from 0 to 2 volts, gain should be set to have the output be just below 2 volts when the capacitor is replaced with short circuit. That allows you to use the whole range for the measurements. How different ESR values will affect the reading between the maximum output voltage and 0 volts depends on this resistor, the one that forms the voltage divider with capacitor being tested. While you could calculate things and make the microcontrollers translate the measured voltage to an actual ESR value, that's not always necessary. For fault finding, it's enough to have a good, not good, scale. Test what reading is with 0.1 ohm, 1 ohm and 10 ohm resistors. This will give some kind of ballpark for 1000 microfarad, 100 microfarad and 10 microfarad capacitors. You could make a coarse bar display with few LEDs, numerical display that shows the reading, or add an analog voltmeter to the output to show the reading in old school way. Either way, you should test some known values and judge the readings based on those reference readings. This video was meant to explain how typical DIY ESR meter tester works, so you can make one for yourself with your favorite components. PSoC 4 is one of my favorite microcontrollers because of its versatility. This project didn't use anything that couldn't be replaced with jelly bean parts like generic op amps and 555 timer. See you next video. Thanks. Bye.